We need to figure out how to make this more liquidy. So we need to get it warm. I'm gonna heat some water and put it in the stainless steel bowl and then put this down in it and it'll make the honey warm and then we can pour it out better and whisk it in better. Or easier. Okay. French toast, so we have to sweeten the batter.
We don't have any sugar.
The egg batter?
Yeah. Okay. Hey y'all, welcome back to Blue Ridge Farmstead. I'm Stephanie and
Selma.
This is Selma. We're making homemade French toast today. That's what Selma requested for breakfast, although it's after lunch already. That's okay, you can have French toast any time of the day. Delicious, isn't it?
It's a bad thing to
eat. Okay, so to get started, I'm taking a loaf of homemade bread I made earlier in the week.
Yeah.
When you make homemade bread, it only, because there's no preservatives, it only stays good for like 3 days before it starts getting pretty tough. And so French toast is a great way to use up homemade bread. Especially if it starts getting to where you can't like toast it or use it for sandwiches or something like that. So the first thing I'm going to do is slice off a couple of fairly thick slices of homemade bread. And I'm only making this for so much. You'll probably only need two, won't you?
Three.
Well, we'll start out with two.
Okay.
The first thing we want to do is make our batter. So we want to pour a little bit of milk into a stainless steel bowl. Okay, that'll be good. We'll start with that. Okay. We'll use a little bit of cream. Let's put a little bit of cream in there too. Just a little. Okay, and then one egg, nope, not on the bowl, crack it on the counter, crack it on the counter. Okay, that's good. Nope, looks good, make sure you get all the white in there. Okay, you just put that to the side over there. And to that, get in and wash your hands. To that, we're going to add ground cinnamon. And ground nutmeg. I eyeball this. I eyeball almost everything I cook. So this is the nutmeg. I definitely won't use as much of it as I will the cinnamon. And then I'll let you pour the vanilla. Mmm, cinnamon smells so good. Let's pour in the vanilla. Looks good. Let's get a whisker. Let's work up that yolk really good and just whisk it together. And let's see how much liquid we have. With homemade bread, you're gonna be able to soak up quite a bit of batter. Especially with these slices being a little bit thicker. So let's do this. Really whisk it together.
I didn't want to spill it.
Looks pretty yellow, and that's just because the yolks of our chicken eggs are quite dark. Let's add a little bit more milk just to make sure that we are going to have enough. All right, that should be good. The last thing we're going to do, okay, you're going to have to pause. We need to add the honey in. The last thing we want to do is add in the honey, and I'm going to do this part.
Okay.
This is honey that we got out of our hive back in the fall, and it's really thick, and the way that we make it a little bit thinner and easier to pour is I just sat it down in a stainless steel bowl, and I poured some hot water around it, and it's nice and warm, and it's very runny right now, so I can actually pour it and whisk it in. So get the whisk ready. And I'm gonna pour in the honey. I'm gonna go for probably about a quarter cup. Okay, let me see this. All right. Now we're gonna lay our pieces in, and while they're soaking up the batter, and they will, they'll soak it up. While they're soaking up the batter, we're gonna get our pan hot. When I make French toast, I'm very generous with butter because I think it makes the best crust around the edges when you put good quality butter and a lot of it in the pan. So let's turn this on. This is a big burner, so I'm just gonna put it on low. Okay, what we can do, we can actually flip these pieces over so they can soak up on the other side. Okay. And while the butter is melting in this pan, they're going to continue to soak it up.
Okay.
All right. Let's put us a good pat of butter in there for two pieces of French toast. I'll tell you, are you sure you'll eat three? If you're sure you'll eat three, I'll make another.
I might. Let me eat these two.
Well, maybe we can make another one just in case Lawson might want one. Okay? Since we've got enough batter in there, that'll be fine too. Okay. Can you get down and put these two back in the fridge for me, please? All right, let's add just a little bit more butter in there.
Should I put this?
Not yet. Okay, just a short plug for the dairy that we use. About, I would say maybe 4 months ago, we came across some folks who put us on to a local dairy. They're located in Hamptonville, North Carolina, and this is called Wholesome Country Creamery. What a find. We've never had better milk, better cream, better ice cream.
The best chocolate milk.
The best chocolate milk. The yogurt is phenomenal. We love, love, love their kefir. Their milk kefir is delicious. The butter is amazing. They sell grass-fed dairy, non-GMO production practices.
Can I flip it now?
We love that local creamery. If you are in our area and would like some great local dairy, you need to check them out.
That looks good.
That's a great sizzle. Yeah.
This one.
Make room for that third one. Your whisk out of the way. Okay. Sometimes I'll make just, if there's a little well in there, I can pour a little extra batter over on top. Oh man, that's some creamy goodness right there. And then, a long time ago, before we got rid of our pigs, this will go to the pigs. But now we'll give it to the cats and see if they like it. All right, take a look at that. You can see how that's bubbling up in there. If you've got a good non-stick skillet, you'll be able to just slide those pieces around. French toast, sometimes it's hard to tell when it's ready to flip. You just have to kind of lift and eyeball. Let's let it go for a few more minutes. I've got the burner on the lowest setting. Is it yummy?
Mm-hmm.
All right, there you have it. Homemade French toast using up homemade bread. So the homemade bread recipe that we use comes from the Sullivan Family Homestead. I found them on YouTube. She has a video, it's several years old, but it is Amish white bread that uses a KitchenAid mixer. And so I've made homemade bread before without the KitchenAid stand mixer, and it was not easy. So this is so easy. In fact, she calls it easy peasy white bread. My kids love this. And I will also link that YouTube video in the description box below. Okay guys, thanks for watching. If you guys are enjoying this content, then be sure to hit the subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, and share this with your friends. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye.